Hello and a warm welcome to another edition of To The Point. With less than a month to go for the Karnataka polls, the political temperatures are rising with a three-cornered fight between Congress, BJP and the JDS. While the two national parties are flexing their muscles over a range of issues, where does Janata Dal Secular stand today in the political framework of Karnataka? Joining me now is National President of JDS, sitting Lok Sabha MP from Hassan and former Prime Minister, Mr. H.D. Devagowda. I welcome you on the program.
Thank you.
Mr. Gowda, my first question to you is, what people are wondering that what are the prospects of Janata Dal Secular when the two national parties are so aggressively pitting against each other?
The two national parties, what was the damage that has happened to Karnataka when they were in office? Vajpayee was the Prime Minister for 6 years and Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister for 10 years. Now, Narendra Modi is the Prime Minister for almost 4 years. 20 years, how a state like Karnataka has been suffered is an issue which is now the people of Karnataka wants to know from them. It is not me. The people of Karnataka wants to know these two national parties, what was the justice they have done to Karnataka on the issue of sharing the Kaveri waters or on the development activities like highways and railways. And all these are the major issues which the people wants to know. I was only 10 months Prime Minister. What I have done during the short period of 10 months, that is also before me and before the people of Karnataka. So their politically awareness has been there. They will understand in 10 and a half months what Mr. Gowda has done to Karnataka with 13 party coalition.
But when you say that the other two national parties were in power, JDS was also in power in Karnataka. Now, people will also try and equate and see what JDS, when it was in power, what did it do for the people?
I was the chief minister for 1.5 years, just 18 months. What you have done during that 18 months? See, what the social justice that has been done to the people of Karnataka, whether they are minorities. First time in India, the problem of the minorities was solved. Eidgah Maidan issue, where the two national parties were trying to fight this issue, to keep this issue alive and get the benefit. While I have been in office, I have not bothered about the election benefits. I want to create peace and harmony in my state. The issue was stalled. I took oath on 11th December and I solved this problem on January 26th. Just about 30-35 days, the whole problem was solved. The people today are peaceful. Eidgah Maidan issue, which was solved by me about 23 years back, even today, not even a single disturbance. Whereas these two political parties created the problem in Mangalore 7 or 8 months back. More than 12 people have butchered, because the fight is both the parties.
Mr. Gowda, when this Eidgah Maidan issue happened, of course it was years back and people do have memories about it, but it's the same Congress party which is now accusing JDS. The entire definition of secularism which is practiced by JDS is being questioned by parties like Congress. So why do you think Rahul Gandhi and Siddaramaiah are asking you to come clean on secularism?
I am not going to blame Rahul Gandhi. He's an youngster. He's an youngster, yet he has to go a long way to get himself prepared to occupy the gaddi of the Prime Minister. He has to go a long way. But the person who was with me, whose base was built up by Devagowda or by the JDS, where is Siddaramaiah? He questioned one of the Congress leaders who left Congress and joined with me. He used to say, your mother was Congress. And what Siddaramaiah can say? Who was the mother of the Siddaramaiah? Is it JDS or Congress? See, please understand, by desperation, frustration, he talks like that. Rahul Gandhi is not a person to accuse me. When he has realized that these people try to mislead him, in last two visits, he never spoken anything about JDS. First part of
this. So how does one read? If Rahul Gandhi has not spoken anything against JDS, so is that an indication that probably if need be, and if JDS gets an opportunity to become a potential kingmaker, will you ally with Congress?
Please, the question of a kingmaker either going with BJP or with Congress is ruled out.
Okay.
What? I was a prime minister. I know the political system of this country. What made me to go to behind Mayawati? Mayawati based in Karnataka. She fought two elections on her own, and she got about more than 25 assembly constituencies. Today in India, she is the tallest leader among the scheduled caste leaders in the country.
Your party has already allied with BSP, but I think your party is also in talks with parties like NCP. What is happening on that front? Are you going to ally with more parties?
Yes. NCP, I myself dropped. I have not talked to NCP. He himself, Sharad Pawar, talked to me.
Okay.
And he wants to share the seats with me. But the recent development, the NCP is associated with Maharashtra Ekikaran Samiti, were deadly opposed.
Okay.
That's why that idea has been dropped. We're only going ahead with BSP.
Your party's alliance with BSP, of course, in Karnataka is at a smaller level. Is it also an indication for the larger battle of 2019, where probably your party and BSP will form some kind of a third front, a national third front?
I'm not going to speak about the third front as a national front.
Mm-hmm.
There are some people who have got, some people want a national, the permutation and combination with all regional parties and the national party.
Right.
But I am not going to now extend my area of working beyond Karnataka. First, I want to fight this battle. Then, once it is settled, whether to spare some time, I am already 85, let us be frank, whether to spare some time to go beyond Karnataka is an issue. I have not yet made up my mind. Of course, Kumar Swami is a youngster who can take decision when once his government is going to be formed.
Mr. Gowda, you were just talking about the alliances. There is also a larger feeling that BJP has facilitated your alliance with BSP so that the Dalit votes, which could have gone to the Congress, would now be split.
While fighting this grand opportunity, Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister, has Mayawati taken any little concession to Congress, sympathy to Congress, thrown the Congress and the BJP out, and Akhilesh Yadav and Mayawati comes together. They destroyed the golden opportunity of Chief Minister and Deputy Chief Minister. It's a golden opportunity. See, as explained from the national media, she is so smart. It's not so simple to assess Behenji Mayawati.
Now let's talk about the issues which have been raised in this election. Many people feel that it is an issue-less election with the kind of issues which have been raised. For example, now Siddaramaiah has appropriated the Kannadiga pride by talking about the state flag issue. So do you think that somewhere down the line now national parties have started appropriating the issues which were flagged by the regional parties? What do you feel, sir?
If I speak a little harsh word, whether Congress is going to be a party which is a national party where its high command was having the superpower. Now those days are over. In the entire country, Congress has lost state by state. They are only depending upon Siddaramaiah and his money resources. state is looted. His money resources is one of the major issue where the Congress, the senior leaders cannot open their lips. It is Siddaramaiah's Congress. I am not making a speech which is not relevant. I am speaking with all sincerity. It may command, only Siddaramaiah is dictating the Congress today.
Okay.
Only for the outside consumption. Oh, Rahul Gandhi will make next Prime Minister. Who is he? Can he expand his political power outside Karnataka? Can he? Has he grown to that level? I know the media is managing. Every 2 seconds is with Karnataka, the Lobo. He is making all type of irrigation, power, this, that. He is spending 650 crores for the publicity.
So you mean to say that they are, parties like Congress are not raising the real issues. They are just tom-tomming their achievements through fake publicity.
200%. 2,000%. I stand by on this issue. I can prove it.
So is your party making an effort to expose parties like Congress?
JDS is fighting to expose. I don't know what is Bharatiya Janata Party, whether they are in a position to fight this battle, because Siddaramaiah is more aggressive on the Prime Minister.
Okay.
He is more aggressive and he is showing that, who is that Modi? I can't speak.
So if you are saying that Siddaramaiah is more aggressive than the Prime Minister, so if the choice, if the election results...
He says, Devagoda is an opportunist. That is the only charge he can make, otherwise he can't make. Can he make any corruption charges against me or my son? Come on. Let him open his lips.
But Mr. Gowda, if the election results come out as a hung verdict, if it is a hung assembly, you will ally with BJP or you will go with Congress?
Why you are expecting that today? It's too
early. No, I'm just talking about a possibility. We have always seen that JDS has its own limitations.
Please, please, it is a hypothetical question.
Okay.
Please. He claims I am going to get more than 120, Siddaramaiah. And the Bharatiya Janata Party, the Prime Minister, has not entered Karnataka after the notification. And he is going to stay here for to address 90 meetings. You know, he is more, I think, turbulent speaker than Vajpayee. I don't know what type of speeches he is going to make against Siddaramaiah. May not be against me because I am behaving within my limitations.
Okay. Is that an indication that you have a soft heart for
BJP? As a former Prime Minister, to attack the sitting Prime Minister, I must be restrained.
Okay.
I never attacked Vajpayee. I never attacked Manmohan Singh.
Mr. Gowda, Congress also says that there is a feeling that JDS it has a tacit understanding with the BJP. They have already started saying that Janata Dal Secular is Janata Dal Sangh Parivar and you are BJP's B team. Congress says this.
Who says?
Congress says this.
Which Congress? Siddaramaiah's Congress?
Siddaramaiah's Congress.
Then that means we have now accepted the Congress is only Siddaramaiah.
No, even the central leaders say that. Even the central leaders say that, sir.
See, nothing other than Siddaramaiah. Who has no other allegation against me or my son, because he can't, except saying opportunist. He, to become the Chief Minister, he rushed to the doors of Sonia Gandhi, fall on her feet. A self-respected man, a man who has got some self-respect, would have gone to that stage. He went to Bombay, fall on the feet of S.M. Krishna when he was a governor. Wanted to become the Chief Minister, losing the self-respect. Now today, after he becomes the Chief Minister, he has thrown Krishna out. He is now talking Devagoda, irrelevant in Karnataka politics. He is such an ungrateful fellow.
Siddaramaiah has also taken a lead in according the minority religion status to Lingayats. Do you feel that this particular issue, it benefits Congress in some way or the other, or Congress stands a chance to gain from this issue?
I pity for Siddaramaiah's calculation. Lingayats ruled Karnataka for 25 years. It is a community which has got political awakening. Even after this dirty thing that has happened, it is only because of Siddaramaiah calculated to split Lingayats.
Mr. Gowda, if Lingayats are divided, which party stands to gain by this splitting of the votes, the Lingayat votes?
They are politically awareness they have got.
Okay.
They are not going to be divided. While voting, they have got their own idea whether to support the Bharatiya Janata Party or JDS or Congress.
Okay.
They will take their own decision. It is not so easy to assess the Lingayat community.
Mr. Gowda, talking particularly about the prospects of JDS, your legislators have even quit the party. Now, what do you think was the reason why they had to leave the party?
Some Congress MLAs have left the party. Giant BJP. You are not blaming them. Recently. Similarly, some BJP MLAs also left the party. You are not blaming them. If one or two MLAs from my party goes, you are blaming me. What can I say?
Supposing if once the results are out and BJP and Congress both knock at the doors of JDS, are you going to listen to BJP
again,
or you listen to Congress?
You are again asking me a hypothetical question. That may not arise. Why?
So if you're saying that the situation may not arise, how many seats are you hopeful of getting once the results are
out? I am expecting to form the government on my own, minus Congress and minus Bharatiya Janata Party.
Okay.
Yes, there may be some few independents. With this type of combination, I still hope to form the government on my own.
But what makes you feel so positive, Mr. Gowda? Because your party also has some limitations. Your MLAs are concentrated in a particular region in Karnataka. So what makes you feel so effusively positive?
What I have done to Hyderabad, Karnataka, or Bombay, Karnataka, as Prime Minister, as Irrigation Minister, as Peter, the Chief Minister, things are, we can list the achievements what I have made.
So, which
so
means
these are not the issues. The media try to give a version that Devagowda JDS is only old Mysore, where Vakligas are there.
Mr. Gowda, you've been known as a humble farmer who became the Prime Minister, and your party is also promising a loan waiver of 52,000 crores, which is not a small amount. Now, everybody is wondering, how is Mr. Gowda going to do it if your party comes back to power? How are you really going to do it, and what is the kind of stress which it is going to have on the state treasury?
Siddaramaiah has forgotten, was the Finance Minister. Mm-hmm. In 1995, we waived, the Scheduled Bank and regional banks and cooperative banks, the interest, penal interest, then the another baddi, mari baddi, susti baddi, like that we'll call, three types of the interest will compound interest. So, all these interest comes to 960 crores.
Okay.
Into 1994 or 5. Manmohan Singh Finance Minister, Prime Minister Narasimha Rao, you know the financial situation in that, at that time, gold were mortgaged. Please, 150 tons of gold was mortgaged. Chandrasekhar period, 4 months, 30 tons. I know these things. At that time, Mr. Narasimha Rao said, we cannot allow this.
Okay.
NABARD, Reserve Bank said, we can't. Then I said, I will go for a hunger strike if you can't. Then, of course, Narasimha Rao shows some sympathy. called this great Manmohan Singh subject to repayment by me. I accepted that condition. 960 crores is not a small amount about 23 years back. It can be compared with 90,000 or whatever the quantity of inflation, money value. At that time, we not only waived, we reimbursed that money.
Okay.
In addition to other burdens which I have carried at that time. The previous Moili government was brought loan from a private company, Fearless Finance Company, Calcutta, to pay the salaries of the employees. That was the situation when I took the responsibility of the reign of administration in 94. So these are all the issues. I am a farmer. What was my budget? 96. Please go through my budget, 97.
Okay, so you're hopeful that you will give a loan waiver, a complete loan waiver of 52,000 crores.
This amount may be required 1 month.
Okay.
The quantum of loot, Kumar Swami was appointed a committee while he was a chief minister. 45,000 of prime land was looted by these two parties. And he wants to take steps. By the time his government is gone, each acre of land is going to cost more than 10 crores. Each acre of land. See, the money is in Bangalore, is in the hands of these looters. You know how to act. There is no need to go to Reserve Bank or to anybody's house. It is in the looters, this thing, pocket.
Next question is that you just spoke about the fact that you don't speak against the prime ministers, and you've never spoken much against Manmohan Singh, neither have you spoken against Narendra Modi. But people have been talking about the fact that Narendra Modi has been one prime minister whose personality and his dynamism is just matchless. Do you think that the Modi charisma prevails in the state of Karnataka, or Amit Shah will be successful with his strategies to woo the voters here?
What was the charisma that was there in 2014, in 2019, slowly denigrated, goes on coming down. That charisma is not there. He himself knows it. He is now worrying himself. We know that. What happened to Notbandi? What happened to GST? See, what happened to the cashless society wants to create. All these things, he has got some high thinking, but in practical, he was not able to achieve.
Say,
thinking is not implementing. Your thinking must be penetrated to the lower level, to the beneficiaries. Mere thinking cannot be a solution. Thinking is one part, implementation is the other part.
But sir, as far as your party is concerned, many political parties are accusing JDS of the fact that it practices family politics, it's involved in dynasty politics. So how will you really address the real issues before the people when your party is so entrenched in the dynasty and the family politics?
Modi sahab was so tough. How many people of his party, their children were contested in Uttar Pradesh? Rajnath Singh's son is not contested. No, I am not making a joke. Modi has no children. That's why he's, yes, I will not allow. I do agree.
So basically, you're not against dynasty politics.
I am not going to take the shelter. Sonia Gandhi, Nehru, Indira. Is not the issue. We are not going to through the backdoor entry. Whether my son or my grandson, we are not going to the backdoor entry, either Raj Sabha or Council. If they are going to be elected by the people of Karnataka, why should anybody grudge? If Siddaramaiah's son is contesting in Orana, why should I bother on that? If X daughter is going to contest, why should I bother? if Rahul Gandhi contest, if Sonia Gandhi contest, or Priyanka contest, why should I bother on this?
So dynasty politics is not a very big issue according to you.
See, in India, now why do you say India? Senior Bush is also contested. Junior Bush also contested. Why do you only confine to India? Please.
Okay. My last question.
They are not relevant.
Okay. Mr. Gowda, my last question before I wind up the show. You are a very senior politician and someone who's had a legacy of more than 5 decades into politics. How would you really like yourself to be remembered now that you are at the helm of affairs of JDS? What is your legacy?
There is no legacy here. My father was a small farmer, having about 10 acres of dry land. Please. My great-grandfathers are not politicians. They are small farmers in a small village. By the grace of God, I don't know, by the grace of God, or my father and mother or my ancestors had got great belief in Lord Shiva. Where devotees of Lord Shiva, please. Might have I born in such a family, never expected my father and mother, my son will go up to the office of the Prime Minister. Never, never. My father died earlier when I was in jail, emergency. Please. He don't know what my son is going to be. But anyway, Lord Bhagwan pushed me up to that stage. I said it in the parliament. The divine force brought me here. I don't know whether my son was a film producer, Kumar Swami, or Revana was an agriculturist after his completion of his education. Only SSLC. And he was forced to contest in Hassan, in Vadanashpur for Jilla Panchayat. I don't know. All these issues is only accidental.
But is your entire family not planning to jump into politics? Because we've heard that H.D. Kumar Swami is also fighting from PC.
I myself asked him to go for higher studies, M.Tech or whatever. One grandson has gone. He has passed MBA, he's in business. Similarly, I advised him. All others are doctors, grandchildren. I may, as already told you, I will not going to contest in 2019 election. I told my grandson, because other senior leaders does not want to contest the parliament election in the district. I got several leaders in my party and I have tested their mind. They are all asking me to contest. I don't want to contest. I already told I may allow my grandson to contest the parliament election. Let me be frank, there is nothing to hide. It is not a legacy. It is only, I don't know the will of God, whether you call it legacy or it is accidental, I can't say.
It was a pleasure talking to you, Mr. Gowda, on the program.
I am equally happy, madam. I must thank the Rajya Sabha TV. Thank you very much.
So that's it on this episode of To The Point. See you next time with another personality. Goodbye and thanks for watching.